So, Game 1, Smashville, Fox vs. Villager, let's go. So we can see like, nice zone break into Villager's opening. For David Tech, interesting for the tournament organizer, who is also a Villager himself. Yeah, we can see like the dynamic in this matchup. Fox is already building up a lead and puts Villager back to the ledge. I mean, Fox especially is a character that has really strong ledge trapping, so we might see that more than once in the set, as you can see. Interesting.
Especially with the advantage, not trying to
commit to any option.
Yes.
Playing it safely down. Though I think he gives his opponent a little bit too much time, but I think that's taste, right?
Yeah. But he has such a strong lead, I think he can afford that.
That's true too. Oh, really great spacing from the sweet spot neutral air to prevent any kind of punishment. I think Fogo might start to find his grounding a little bit. He probably is a little bit overwhelmed when it comes to Fox's speed. Oh, it was a really nice hard read.
Oh. And the taunt, of course.
Yeah, come on.
Will we see the taunt to get party combo?
Oh, right. He's teabagging him. Let's see. We have to see how Fogo adapts to Specht's playstyle. I think Specht is playing a really good hot and cold game right now. Like he played a lot of played really patiently, forced ledge traps, and his neutral was very calculated.
Yeah.
But right now he's way more aggressive when it comes to approaching. Oh, nice. Yeah, that's actually quite tough as a villager. You don't have that many tools to punish an opponent that crosses up your shield, because his shot up is way too high for Fox to get a back air slingshot. Ooh, interesting.
The only option would be Nair out of shield.
Yeah, he tried it but got punished for it. That's interesting. Oh, he even got the triple turn, but you shouldn't really try to contest Fox's up air.
Yeah.
Even if it trades, you see what happens, you still lose.
Nice game from Specht.
Yeah, really well played.
Convincing.
Yeah. Used his superior mobility and frame data to pressure Fogo in every area, probably. You can see Fogo thinking what he did wrong, what he could have done better to prevent Fox from breaking his zone. Because what you want as a villager, you want to establish like a wall of projectiles or a smart wall of projectiles that you can cover any approaching options. But we see Fogo switching to Charizard, interesting, trying to get Specht with the unknown matchup experience. Or minimal matchup inexperience in this case. So let's see, still Smashville. Let's go, interesting. Yeah, Charizard is a really interesting character, has a really good jab, like his jab's probably his best move. Frame 4, deals 12%, has a ridiculous range. So let's see how Fogo will try to combat that.
Of course, with any big character, Fox tries to get in through the air.
Yeah.
But with big characters, they can just throw out a smash attack and catch him with an anti-air.
That's true. So approaching heavyweights from the air can be sometimes difficult, and because they have like really lingering hitboxes and SD.
Oh.
They really have lingering hitboxes and sometimes even intangible ones. For example, Charizard's up there, you cannot trade with that move. Interesting. Oh, yeah. He went for the down throw fair, but didn't have the space to gain momentum for the forward air.
So this move to the down B.
The rock smash.
It has super armor, I think.
Ooh, interesting setup. Yeah, he tried to go for the down air reset to footstool, but he unfortunately mistimed this. Fogo right now being quite fortunate when it comes to recovering to the stage. He has found quite some openings when it comes to recovering. The lack of pressure from Specht really allows him to get back on stage, as you could see. Ooh, interesting up smash.
Very well done.
Yeah. Oh, interesting. Oh, I think... I don't play Charizard. Maybe an up throw would have killed, I'm not sure. Ooh, sexy, let's go.
The crowd is pleased with that spike.
Are you not entertained?
Oh. The teabagging.
Yeah. Ich bin echt really cheeky, when it comes to playing the player versus player game. Oh, interesting, well done. Oh, damage. Oh, he unfortunately B-reversed his move. I think he may have gotten another edge guard situation, sadly. He missed. Nope. Oh, really fast mash outbreak, Specht.
One thing we can see from Specht is that he doesn't even try to combat him off stage.
Yeah.
Because he knows it's too much risk. And
the reward is way too low for the risk it takes.
Yeah.
High risk, low reward, that's true.
He's playing his stage advantage, his stage game. Like we see, he puts up a wall with his back airs.
Yeah, that's what I was about to say though, but jumping is a commitment.
Yeah.
And Vogel called that out really well with an up smash, because it's probably one of the best anti-airs in the game. And it kills. So Vogel just needs... Oh, interesting. Oh, now he's unfortunate. Yeah, he was pretty much checkmate at this situation. There was basically nothing that he could have done. He may have went for a flare blitz to damage the shield and then maybe do a beefy up B with the up B recovery. But in a pressure situation like this, you don't think through that many layers.
Yeah, right.
So,
will Pogu come back from this deficit?
It's basically up to him. Specht is playing well and patient. Let's go! No. Oh. Teasing me with the link.
Yeah.
I think Vogel should stay to Charizard because game 2 was way more even than game 1. I think he was clueless in game 1. He didn't really know what to do. And I think it's realistic from him that he says, I cannot adapt, so I have to pick another character.
Yeah, right. It seemed like Specht had the right answers for Villager, but struggled a little bit more against Charizard.
Yeah, because Charizard is like, it's a curveball. It's a really uncharacteristic character.
Always with these big hard hitters, there's always the clutchness factor, comeback that's possible. Yeah.
We can see Vogel playing a really well game right now. Basically denying any recovery option from Fox and punishing those that he takes. And now the combo start, but
he catches him.
Yeah. Charizard is heavy. He won't die pretty early. He will abuse Rage. Ooh, an interesting choice. Oh. Wow, that was a call out. Really lucky. Sometimes the side B has like a blind spot where you cannot hit Fox out of, and that was a situation where you could see that really well.
He also went for the high.
Ooh! Challenging the entire from Specht. I think patience is key for Charizard. He basically needs a down throw, and then he can do like anything he wants. I think Vogel has the number when it comes to his Specht's defensive options. I think he called out them really well during this stock. I think he may need one or two moves to even that out. Oh, unfortunate. Pretty fast mesh from Specht 2. Oh, risky. But that won't kill yet. Oh no. He could have probably landed on shield with a rock smash. That itself was would be pretty unsafe, but he was, again, re-grabbing the ledge, and this is pretty vulnerable for any character. And especially with Fox's ledge trapping, that can be troublesome.
Specht knowing that and abusing it with the ledge ledge traps all the time.
Yeah. Vogel tries to ledge drop and to double jump back on stage. Maybe looking for another option. Maybe it's the Villager habit too, like coming back with slingshot. Oh, interesting.
Might be. There.
Oh, call out. You can see that's what you have to do against characters like Zeus with Samus and Fox. They tend to short up a lot to pressure
opponent. Yeah. Force him into making a move and then punching that.
What a lot of people still don't consider that much is that jumping is still a commitment, and you can call that out as Vogel did. Interestingly, Fox is a character that can call out shot-ups pretty well with his running up smash.
Yeah, right. So both characters in kill percent, but space with the stock advantage.
Mm-hmm. But we have Rage Boys. Ooh, that kill definitely across the stage. Sheik, Sheik, Millie Sheik fall there. That's what I call that move. Ooh. You can see the cloud being... Ooh, interesting. Accidental or nice auto-cancelled. Arach. That's quite a close game, to be honest.
Especially now looking for the kill. Is it JV2?
Let's hope not. Let's go Charizard. Ooh.
Nice tomahawk.
Oh, that's really close. Oh, let's go. Come back, boys. I mean, Specht could basically time him out too if he wants to. I mean, we have 150. That's basically more than enough to time out an opponent. Oh, his
shield very low. Too high for the kill confirm.
Oh, yeah.
The neutral get up punished.
That was well done. The lingering hitboxes of Fox's F smash really make it a tempting move to cover neutral get up, and sometimes even ledge jump or any of these options. But it's quite laggy and can get punished pretty easily by a character like Fox or by any lingering move. I think well played to Fogo and Specht. Specht holds his ground, didn't get faced by the counter pick too much. He still found his way in game three to abuse his superior neutral.
We saw that he used his back air really good, put up a wall. Mm. Yeah.
Switched walking by, fist bumping. Now we will have Sir John.